Hello, I'm Dr. Maggie Luther, and today I'm here to talk to you about a very important nutrient known as choline. This is a one powerhouse nutrient, as I hope you'll see by the end of the slideshow today. So, in 1998, the Institute of Medicine decided to recognize choline as an essential micronutrient. That means you mostly get it from your diet. You can make a little bit of it, as you'll see in a little by your liver, but it's not an efficient pathway. And so, what the Institute of Medicine did was they set adequate intake levels, and you can see those listed here. And so, adequate intakes are really only set to prevent deficiency. And so, what that means is that these levels are set to prevent fatty liver, because if you don't have enough choline in your diet, then your liver begins to store fat. And when liver becomes fatty, it can't do its job as well as it should. In fact, those cells don't really operate normally at all. And so 90% of Americans are deficient in choline. And so if 90% of Americans aren't even meeting the adequate intake, a high likelihood of them, 9 out of 10 people, have some degree of fatty liver going on. So when we start to look at what choline does, we can see that it's got a lot of big jobs. It contributes to the cell membrane, so phosphatidylcholine, sphingomyelin is in the nervous system, so it helps with brain and neurological development in the fetus. Really important to be taken during pregnancy and lactation. We can see that it helps with acetylcholine, which is an important neurotransmitter. It is a methyl donor, so it's part of the methylation cycle, and it contributes to, it creates betaine in the body, and then betaine will contribute to trimethylglycine, which is sort of a backdoor way of converting homocysteine into methionine, and we're going to get into that in another choline sequence. I'm going to probably be doing about four different videos on choline, just because it's such an amazing nutrient, and I really feel like we need to understand a lot more about it, and that people need to know where they can get it in their diet and make sure they're getting more than adequate levels. So most sources of choline come from animal sources. And so you can see here that we've got scallop, shrimp, salmon. You can get it from cod, chicken, turkey, beef, eggs. So collard greens are probably about ninth or tenth on the list of foods. So they're ninth or tenth highest in choline. And then there's some other vegetables like Brussels sprouts and kale. So you can definitely get it as a vegetarian, but the best sources are definitely animal sources. And eggs are the best source. You can get about a third, a quarter to a third in one egg. So if you eat two eggs in the morning, you can get half your daily dose of choline. And so when we're thinking about eating this type of food, we want to definitely make sure that it's quality, it's free range, organic when possible, quality meats and animal products so that we can be giving our body what it needs, but not be giving it a lot of excess antibiotics and hormones and things of that nature. So again, good way to get it is through animal sources. If you're a vegetarian, you want to be thinking about collards, Brussels sprouts, broccoli, cauliflower, asparagus, things like that. If you see in my blog article on my site, do have the link to the World's Healthiest Foods, and they give you a nice breakdown of where you can get it both from animal and vegetable sources. Another place you can think about getting it if you don't get enough of it in your diet is to supplement with it. And so the big supplement that we think of is lecithin, and oftentimes this is soy. And so we want to be careful with genetically modified soy. We want to be careful somewhat with non-fermented soy. Another place you could get this is sunflower. So you can get sunflower lecithin supplements, and that can help you get to your daily target so that you're not in the deficiency side of things. If you have trouble getting it through, maybe you're a vegetarian or vegan, you might want to consider supplementing your diet, or if you're pregnant or lactating, you're needing more of it, so you may want to consider supplementing at that point. All right, so please leave a comment or question below. I look forward to sharing more with you next time. Thanks so much.